everyone, Grant K here for the Flame Premium Learning Channel. In this video, we're going to look at a Final Cut Pro XML conform using Camera Raw Media. It is important to note that the offline used the same set of Camera Raw Media. The workflow is actually straightforward, since the same set of media is maintained throughout the production pipeline. If you wish to go through the workflow of conforming a Final Cut Pro XML that was offline using a different version of transcoded media, then please see the other video in this series. There are also other videos that deal with the same topics, but focus specifically on the Avid AAF. Before we go through the various processes, I would like to set the context around this workflow. Firstly, I am using Final Cut Pro 10.1.3 and Flame Premium 2015 Extension 2, which are both current when this video was produced. Secondly, the Camera Raw media I am using is Red Media. This raw format, alongside other formats like ARRIRAW, are filled with metadata that can be used in the conform process. Regardless of what raw format you use, you need to be aware of the media's metadata and ensure its consistency throughout the conforming process. In this scenario, the same red media was used in the offline edit, and it will be used to online and finish the production. During the offline edit in Final Cut Pro, you could choose to optimize the media to ProRes intermediates. This could be for performance reasons. However, the main point is that the metadata will be consistent between the offline and online stages because we are only using a single set of media. And obviously, by ensuring that the metadata matches up, this will result in a successful conform. I will remind you that this differs to the workflow, where the offline is given a separate transcoded version of the media to do the edit, and you are required to do the conform with the original red media. If that is what you're after, please watch the second video on dealing with XML conforming using Camera Raw Media. Finally, during these examples, we can assume that the media might be moved around the facility, and file paths to the media might be different. I will show you one way to conform a timeline, but please bear in mind that with the amount of metadata and options for conforming, there are loads of variations you can try. Starting off in the Media Hub, I like looking at the metadata of the XML before I try to link it to the media. This gives me a better idea of what I'll need to do to the conform. This is purely an optional step, but the value of seeing metadata beforehand is invaluable. So here is my XML file, and I want to import just the sequence with no media. In the AAF and XML import options, I will disable Link to Media Files to stop searching for any media. Now drag the XML clip into the library. Once the clip is created, hold Alt and click on the clip for the metadata pop-up. So this sequence has a resolution of 6144 by 3160 at 10-bit. This is camera native 6K red. In Final Cut Pro, this resolution could have been based on the red media. This is actually the resolution I would like to conform at, but the sequence could be reformatted to a different resolution when we import the XML and link the media. An important reminder is that the media and the sequence should be at the same resolution to avoid unwanted resizes in the edit. Next, I'll switch to the conform area to have a closer look at the metadata for each segment in the sequence. Right-click on the clip and open it as a sequence. If you cannot open the clip as a sequence from the library, you can either drag the clip to the reels and do it there. Or you can go to the General Preference menu and disable Protect from Editing in the Media Library options. Now, looking through the columns, there are a few things I want to point out. The timecode matches the original red media. However, the tape column is read as import and not the embedded tape name. So this is no use to us. Scrolling further along, the file name matches the original red media. So basically, we have two bits of metadata that can be used to identify the correct media files for the conform: the file name and the source timecode. So let's do this for real. Delete the sequence clip and switch back to the Media Hub. The first step is to define the resolution of the media and then the sequence. I'll navigate through the directories to the location of the red media. I'll select any clip and switch to the Format Specific Options tab. The R3D settings should be visible with the selected clip. I'll change the pull-down menu from Metadata to Debayering. Next, I'll set the debayer mode to full. This will display my media at 6K red. I also want the media and sequence to be 10-bit, so I'll switch back to the General tab and change the bit depth to 10-bit on import. If you look at the preview window, you will see the resolution settings that will be applied to all the red media. So that's the media taken care of. Now the XML was generated at the same full debayer resolution of the red media, so we will not need to change its resolution. But if you did, you would switch to the AAF and XML import options, and you can use the resolution embedded in the file, or set a custom resolution for the sequence. Now I'll navigate back to the XML and enable Link to Media Files. One very big point is that the XML has been placed in its own directory. But the red media is in a neighboring directory within the same directory structure. So when I search for the media, Flame needs to step one directory level up and search all the directories and subdirectories from that point. This will include the directory with all the red media. If the media you are conforming to is not within the vicinity of the XML file, you can also use the set search location function as a post operation after importing the XML. This will allow you to search in any location for the media if required. Now, thinking back to the original metadata in the XML, the file name and timecodes match the original red media. So in terms of a search and match criteria, enable file name and source timecode. Finally, drag the XML into the library. Once the conform is complete, switch to the conform area and open the clip as a sequence. All the media should now be linked to the sequence. If you scroll through the event list again, all the metadata should now be correctly pointing to the R3D media. From this point, you could switch to the timeline area and begin working on the sequence. As a reminder, the XML was edited in Final Cut Pro using Camera Raw Media. We took the XML into Flame and conformed it to the same Camera Raw Media. However, if you've been given a Final Cut Pro XML that was edited using a transcoded version of the Camera Raw Media, then you may want to watch the second video on XML conforming with Camera Raw Media. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Flame Premium Learning Channel for future videos.